गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू क्रिस्टल इंटरनेशनल पब्लिक स्कूल ऑनलाइन लर्निंग फॉर द ईयर 2021-22. माई सेल्फ सुनैना गर्ग एंड आई विल टेक योर इंग्लिश एज वेल एज ग्रामर. आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू टेंसेस एज रिविजन. वी विल डू ऑल द टेंसेस इन डिटेल. आर फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच. As we have our parts of body, all the parts together make our body. In the same way, there are different parts of speech, and all the parts together they make speech language. So let's start with our first chapter, parts of speech. Students, you have learned this chapter in your previous class, parts of speech in 6th and 7th standard. We will revise all the parts of speech in 8th class also. So let's start. As you know, there are 8 parts of speech. How many parts of speech are there? 8 parts of speech. Now, these parts of speech are divided into different categories according to their function in the sentence. So let's begin with the parts of speech. The first one is noun. Which is the first one? Noun. As you know, noun is the name of a person, place, thing, or an animal. Examples are given. John. John is the name of a person. Anita is also a person. Delhi is the name of place. Chennai, place. Boy, girl, person. Table, thing. Okay. Honor, gold. These are the nouns. Now, we all know that nouns have number, gender, case, and are of 5 kinds. Now, which are the types of nouns that we will study in next chapter, okay, in detail. But you know there are 5 types of nouns. Which are they? Common noun, proper noun, collective noun, abstract noun, and material noun. Okay, these are the 5 parts, kinds of nouns. Understood? Now let's start pronoun. Understood noun? Noun is a name of a person, place, animal, or thing, and it has number, gender, case, and 5 kinds. Now the second one is pronoun. The second one is pronoun. A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. What is a pronoun? It is a word used instead of a noun, in place of a noun. For example, again and again, we will not write the name of John is a boy, John is a tall boy, John is an intelligent boy, John is a smart boy. We will not write John, John, John in each and every sentence. Okay, instead of writing John in each and every sentence, what we will use for John? We use he. We use he. So he is pronoun. He is the pronoun. Okay. Same way, she is used for girl. They is used for plural, for he, she, it. Okay. You, we, I. These all are pronouns. Now, pronouns are also of 7 kinds. Okay. Each and every part of speech is given in detail in each and every chapter for your grammar textbook. Okay. In your grammar textbook. Here, some more pronouns are given, like mine, ours, yours, hers, his, theirs, them, myself, herself, etc. Okay, pronouns have number, singular, plural, gender, feminine, masculine, okay, and are of 7 kinds. Understood pronouns? Now, third one is adjective. Third one is adjective. Adjective is used to qualify or add something to the meaning of a noun. What is an adjective? Adjective is a word which qualifies or adds some meaning to a noun. Noun में कुछ meaning, noun का जो meaning है उसे qualify कर रहा है. For example, flower. This one is flower. Okay, students, pay attention to the pronunciation of the words. Flower. It is called flower, not flower. Okay, and flower is noun and beautiful is an adjective which adds something to the meaning of flower. Which kind of flower? Beautiful flower. Okay, then soldiers. Soldier is noun. Okay, person has soldiers. But 20 adds some meaning to soldiers, qualifies soldiers. Same way food. Food is noun. Cheese ka naam hai, food, thing ka name hai. Okay, and little shows the quantity of food, so it is adjective. Then same thing, daughter, but first qualifies daughter. Which daughter? First daughter. Okay, so first shows the number, so it is adjective of number. Then woman. Okay, students, I will give you one or two information, interesting information, while I'll explain you the chapter. See, what is the pronunciation of woman? W-O-M-A-N is called woman. Okay, and what is the pronunciation of W-O-M-E-N? It is called women, not woman. This one is called women. Okay, so be careful in pronouncing this word. So these words are called adjective. Which words? The words which add or qualify the meaning of a noun is called adjective. Now, next one is verb. Verb. What is a verb? Verb is an action word. Verb is an action word. A verb denotes an action or being or position. Okay, yani ki three types of verbs hain. First one is action words, second one is being verbs, and third one is position. Now action means S-E-S, second form, third form, these are action words. Being means is, am, are, was, were, to be forms. And possessive means has, have. Okay, these are called verbs. So there are three categories of verbs: action verbs, being verbs, and position verbs. You can also say action verbs, then being verbs ko hum log bol sakte to be verbs. Okay, and position verbs ko hum log bol sakte to have verbs. Understood? So these are the three categories of verbs. Now let's see the example. I have a pet dog. This shows position. Yani position yani apne paas hona. Okay, have shows the position. Mere paas mera ek pet dog hai. So it shows position. Kiska position dikha raha hai? Dog ka. So it is possessive verb. Now there are verbs have three chief forms that we all know: present, past, and past participle. Okay, yani ki first form, second form, and third form. For example, what is the first form of begin? Begin. Main form is begin. Second form is begin, and third form is begun. Okay, this is called first form of the verb, this is called second form, and this is called third form. This one is present, this one is past, and this one is past participle. Okay, PP or V3. Here we can say V2, here we can say V1. Okay, in short, we will identify these three forms of verbs as V1, V2, V3. V means verb, verb 1, verb 2, verb 3. Understood? So verbs. So which are the four parts of speech you have learned till now? Noun, Noun is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. Pronoun. Pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. Adjective. Adjective is a word to qualify or add meaning to the meaning, add something to the meaning of a noun. And verb. Verb shows the action, being or position. Understood these four parts of speech? Okay. Now let's start with the examples of verbs. Here, I begin my work at 10 a.m. What is the form of the verb used here? V1. Okay. Second sentence is, I begin my work at 10 a.m. Begin. V2. And third form is begun. It is called V3. So in this way, you have to identify the verb and tense. Now, next parts of speech is adverb. What it is? Adverb. Here, what is the definition of an adverb? An adverb is a word which qualifies a verb, an adjective or another adverb. See, what is an adverb? A word which qualifies a verb or an adjective or another adverb. What is the work of an adverb? To qualify the verb, adjective or an adverb in the sentence. For example, Raman runs quickly. Here, quickly qualifies runs. Kaise pata chal raha hai ki quickly hai? वो क्वालिफाई कर रहा है रन को, तो चेंज करके देख लो, रमन रन्स. अगर ऐसा लिखेंगे फिर भी सेंटेंस कंप्लीट है. ओके, रमन दौड़ता है. ओके, बट कैसे दौड़ता है? क्विकली, फटाफट से, जल्दी से, फास्ट. ओके, सो इट क्वालिफाइज द वर्ब रन्स, सो इट इज एन एडवर्ब. सेकेंड वन इज, दिस पेंटिंग इज वेरी ब्यूटिफुल. नाउ here very is an adverb, because this painting is beautiful likhenge fir bhi chalega, chalega na. But here very adds some quality, more quality. Okay, kuch jyada degree se wo add kar raha hai. Beautiful hai, lekin kaisi beautiful hai? Bahut zyada beautiful hai. Very means bahut. Okay, so very is an adverb which qualifies an adjective in this sentence. Now, third one is, Sundar was crying so loudly. Here, loudly is an adverb. Mostly ly sentences, ly words which are given in the end of the sentence is an adverb. Here, so includes the extent, the degree in the adverb, so it qualifies the another adverb in the sentence. Understood? Adverb. Next one is preposition. Next one is preposition. What is a preposition? A preposition is a word used with a noun or a pronoun to show its relation to some other words in the sentences. It means, प्रेपोजिशन कैसा वर्ड है जो नाउन या प्रोनाउन के साथ यूज होता है, एंड इट शोज द रिलेशन, इट्स रिलेशन टू सम अदर वर्ड्स इन द सेंटेंस. फॉर एग्जांपल, हियर इट इज गिवन, अ कैट हिड अंडर द टेबल. नाउ रिमूव अंडर, अगर अंडर को हटा देंगे हम, अ कैट हिड द टेबल, व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन कैट एंड टेबल इफ वी विल नॉट यूज अंडर? ओके, सो अंडर इज अ वर्ड which is used with a noun. Which noun? The table. Okay, uska relation hai kiske saath hai? A cat. Use show kar raha hai. Okay, a cat hid under the table, so under is the preposition. Second one is, the cat jumped over the hedge. Hedge means, hedge pata hai aapko? हैज जो हमारे वरंडा के बाहर जो होती है ना, बाउंड्री बनी हुई होती है उसकी, फेंस होती है, फिर हैज होती है. ओके, बाउंड्री बनाते हैं. सो द कैट जम्प्ड ओवर द हैज, यानी कि हैज के ऊपर से जंप कर कर आई. अगर ओवर हटा देंगे, इफ वी विल रिमूव ओवर, देन देयर विल बी नो रिलेशन बिटवीन द वर्ड्स गिवन इन द सेंटेंस. ओके, नेक्स्ट वन इज, द कैट स्लेप्ट ऑन द चेयर. हियर ऑल्सो ऑन शोज द रिलेशन बिटवीन द कैट स्लेप्ट एंड द चेयर. तो इन द सेम वे इन आउट अंडर टू फॉर बिहाइंड बीनीथ बिसाइड अबाउट ऑल दिस वर्ड्स आर prepositions. Understood? So till now we have learnt 6 prepositions. Which are they? Noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition. Now 7th one is conjunction. Conjunction. Okay. As soon as you hear the word conjunction, remember it like it is a chain. It is a hook which is used to join two different words together or phrases in the sentence. यानी कि दो अलग अलग words हैं, phrases हैं, sentence हैं, उसे join कर कर एक single sentence बना रहा है. That is called conjunction. Here the example is given, Raman is clever but lazy. So here lazy and clever, these are two words. These are two words. And but is used to join these words together. Okay, but hai ye dono words ko join karne ke liye use hua hai. So it is called conjunction. Next one is, he was a man of courage but of no reputation. Here phrases, man of courage, no reputation, these are the phrases, and but is used to join these two phrases. Okay, next one is, she is fond of, she is fond of music but she hates dancing. So here two different sentences are given. She is fond of music, she hates dancing. These are the two sentences, independent sentences, but is used to join these sentences together, make it single one. Okay, she is fond of music but she hates dancing. Understood? Next one is interjection. An interjection is an exclamatory word denoting some sudden feeling. Okay, यानी कि इंटरजेक्शन है वो क्या है, एक्सक्लेमेटरी वर्ड है विच शोज द फीलिंग, सडन फीलिंग्स जो हम कुछ सुनकर और सडन एक्सप्रेशन देते हैं ना, दैट इज कॉल्ड इंटरजेक्शन. हुर्रा, एलास, आ, ब्रेवो, हाय, ओ, गुड हेवंस, हश, दिस ऑल आर इंटरजेक्शंस बिकॉज दे शो द फीलिंग, इमीडिएट फीलिंग. ओके, सडन फीलिंग है वो बता रहा है, दैट इज कॉल्ड इंटरजेक्शन. वन मोर थिंग यू हैव टू कीप इन माइंड दैट आफ्टर ईच एंड एवरी इंटरजेक्शन, वेन एवर द इंटरजेक्शन इज यूज इन द सेंटेंस, इट इज ऑलवेज एन एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंस. यू हैव टू पुट एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क इन द सेंटेंस. मोस्टली इफ इट इज गिवन, मोस्टली इट इज यूज आफ्टर ईच इंटरजेक्शन लाइक दिस. Here exclamatory mark is given. So after each interjection you will put the exclamatory mark. Okay, I hope you understood all the parts of speech. Quickly revise all the parts of speech. Name the parts of speech. Which are they? Noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, then conjunction, noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction and interjection. Okay, so these are the parts of speech. Now let's start the exercise. Here what you have to do, some parts of speech are given with the underlined words. Okay, you have to write the part of speech of the underlined word. For example, first sentence, you will pass if you work hard. What is if? It is conjunction. Why it is conjunction? Because it has joined two different sentences, so it is conjunction. You can take the screenshot of exercises answers, because I will explain each and every sentence in the video lecture, in Zoom lecture, but for grammar no PDF will be uploaded for this exercises answers. You have to watch the video, you have to attend the Zoom lectures. Is it clear? So you can take screenshot if you want, or you can write with me. Okay, first sentence, you will pass if you work hard. And most important thing is, we will write the answers in textbook if sufficient space is given. ओके अगर ठीक से स्पेस दी है तो वी विल राइट द आंसर्स इन टेक्स्ट बुक विथ पेंसिल. पेंसिल से लिखना है टेक्स्ट बुक में. ओके एंड इफ सफिशियंट स्पेस इज नॉट गिवन दोज एक्सरसाइजेस यू विल राइट इन ग्रामर नोटबुक. इज इट क्लियर? ओके आई रिपीट, यू विल राइट the answers in textbook with pencils where sufficient space is given. I will inform you in each and every exercises where you have to write. So watch the video carefully, attend the lectures carefully. Okay, so first one is conjunction, second one is the new boy was dismissed from service because of misbehavior. So here from is underlined, so what is from? It is preposition. Third one is, my uncle sold his house to a millionaire. Millionaire means जिसके पास बहुत पैसा है. ओके सो ही माई अंकल सोल्ड हिज हाउस टू अ मिलियनर. सो दिस इज अ मिलियनर इज गिवन, सो इट इज अ नाउन. इट इज millionaire suggests the person, so it is noun. Then fourth one is, he generally avoids bad companions. So here generally is an adverb. Generally is an adverb. Fifth one is, this is the beggar who stole my purse. Who is used to relate stole my purse with this is the beggar. Okay, so who is relative pronoun and it is pronoun. Sixth one is, this is the oldest house in Mumbai. Here oldest is underlined. Okay, so what is old? Old is an adjective. You have learnt degrees of comparison in 7th standard, positive, comparative, superlative. Okay, so this is the superlative form of adjective, so oldest is an adjective. Seventh one is, human and animal waste cause pollution. Here V1 is used. Okay, so it is verb. Then 8 number, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. Here 4-5 words are underlined. You have to write each part of speech. All is adjective. What is all? All is an adjective. Okay, I have written in series. Okay, serial number जैसे यहाँ पर underline किया है ना, उसी का answer मैंने यहाँ पर उसी series में लिखा है. You have to write in same series, otherwise the answer will be wrong. Okay, all is an adjective, and is conjunction, play is noun. अब आप बोलोगे मैम play है वो तो verb है, but here play क्या है? नाउन है. वो गेम्स बता रहा है. ओके नो प्ले. मेक्स वर्ब है. ओके मेक्स इज verb. Boy, again noun. Okay, so adjective, conjunction, noun, verb, again noun. Understood? Makes a verb hai. It is not clearly visible here, but makes is a verb. Nine number, ambition, optimism and stamina keeps people going. एम्बिशन ऑप्टिमिज्म ये दोनों चीज़ है वो क्या है नाउन है कौन से नाउन है एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन है ये ओके सो दिस टू आर नाउन ओके नाउन नाउन रिटन ना नाउन नाउन एंड व्हाट इज एंड कंजंक्शन ओके ज्वाइन कर रहा है ना एम्बिशन ऑप्टिमिज्म और स्टेमिना को ज्वाइन कर रहा है एंड सो इट इज अ कंजंक्शन And is conjunction. Okay. Tenth number. Everyone at the party last night was wearing a pirate costume. Everyone and pirate. Everyone है वो pronoun है pirate है वो adjective है क्यों यहाँ पर pirate adjective है कौन से कॉस्ट्यूम पहने थे पायरेट कॉस्ट्यूम पहने थे पायरेट यू नो जो सी में जो लुटेरे होते हैं ना समुंदर में जो लूट चलाते हैं उसे कहते हैं पायरेट ओके सो पायरेट कॉस्ट्यूम तो कैसे कॉस्ट्यूम पायरेट कॉस्ट्यूम सो इट इज़ एन एडजेक्टिव इलेवेंथ नंबर दे बिल्ड लार्ज नेस्ट इन ट्रीज और द वॉल्स ऑफ क्लिफ्स दे प्रोनाउन इन प्रपोजिशन और कंजंक्शन ओके और क्या है कंजंक्शन है देन 12 नंबर ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द लग्जरी कार्स हैव बीन रिकॉल्ड बाय द मैन्युफैक्चरर बिकॉज ऑफ अ डिफेक्टिव मैकेनिज्म ऑलमोस्ट एडजेक्टिव हुआ ओके ऑलमोस्ट एडजेक्टिव हुआ क्योंकि वो लग्जरी कार्स जो हैं उसे क्वालिफाई कर रहा है ऐड कर रहा है मीनिंग बाय है वो क्या हुआ प्रपोजिशन हुआ बिकॉज कंजंक्शन हुआ मैकेनिज्म नाउन हुआ ओके मैकेनिज्म इज नाउन सो यू हैव टू राइट अकॉर्डिंगली मैकेनिज्म इज नाउन 13 नंबर 13 प्राइजेस विल बी गिवन आउट फॉर द ग्रैंड ड्रॉ 13 इज एडजेक्टिव हाउ मेनी प्राइजेस नंबर दिखा रहा है 13 इज एडजेक्टिव विल बी गिवन आउट एडवर्ब गिवन आउट आउट है एडवर्ब हुआ शो कर रहा है गिवन वर्ब में मीनिंग ऐड कर रहा है एंड फॉर इज प्रपोजिशन ओके फॉर इज प्रपोजिशन 14 नंबर द क्राउड डिस्पर्सिस एज द फायरमैन प्रिपेयर टू लीव डिस्पर्सिस इट इज वर्ब Disperses is verb because as is used. Okay, present tense hai. 15 number. 2 days after our argument, 2 days after our argument, my friend apologized for his rudeness. So after your adverb. क्यों adverb है? क्योंकि वो कुछ add कर रहा है noun में यहाँ पर our argument. Okay. माय है यहाँ पर क्या है एडजेक्टिव है आप बताओगे मैम माय तो प्रोनाउन है माय प्रोनाउन भी होता है बट हियर माय इज़ यूज्ड एज एन एडजेक्टिव एंड इट इज़ पजेसिव एडजेक्टिव हियर अपोलोजाइज्ड इज वर्ब एंड फॉर इज प्रपोजिशन ओके सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर एंड फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड एवरीथिंग इन एक्सरसाइजेस ऑल्सो And in the explanation part also. You can take the screenshot of this exercise's answer and write the answer in textbook only in the series given. Okay, जो series में मैंने answer लिखे ना उसी series में आपको भी answer लिखने हैं. And if any doubt is there, you can ask in our Zoom lecture. Okay, so we will meet in next lecture with your English literature book. So be ready with your English literature book for the next lecture. Till then, bye.